A new feature for the Airtable Forms is now allowing us to hide and yet still pre-fill a field on a form. So if you've ever wanted to share a form and pre-fill some information, but then hide that particular field element from the form, you're in luck because that is exactly what we're talking about in this video. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, where I make it my mission to help you save 20 hours or more of your time every week with no-code tools. If that's of interest and you want to learn more about that, the cornerstone of productivity is leveraging the power of automation. So check out my free automation webinar where I teach you the building blocks, the fundamentals of no-code automation so that you can start reclaiming your time and letting your automations run in the background doing all your repetitive tasks. If that's of interest, check it out at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. But without further ado, let's hop into the heart of this video where we're talking about, yes, the new ability to create a form, pre-fill an element of a form, and then hide that field from the form so that people don't make changes to it. So let's first start, as we always do, with our simple data structure. In this example, as you see, I have contacts and then a link to the form capture. So I have people in my contacts table, in this case, Gareth, Peter, and Captain. I have a last name and then an email address. This is then linking to a form, and we are recording these form submissions in a second table. The form submission is going to ask what the favorite color is and maybe for a favorite restaurant. So let's see how this form might look. We haven't actually built the form yet, so we have to create that. We'll go ahead and make this form, and of course, we see that there's a link to the contacts, and this is where we're going to store who submitted this form. We also have a favorite color here. This is the question. We can make this a list. We could limit it to certain options or make it conditional, and same thing with the favorite restaurant. Now, I'm not going to go too much into this because I've done previous videos about how to set up excellent forms in Airtable. And if you're curious about how to write a nice formula that helps you pre-fill a form, I have recently done a video on that very topic, and I will link it to this video. But for this particular case, we want to go a step further and actually hide that element from the form. Now, Airtable support has added this to the documentation for pre-filling forms. So on this particular support page for this topic, you see there's now an option for hiding and pre-filling a field from the submitter's view. Of course, we're starting here with the actual URL of the particular form that we have generated, which I'll show you how to get in just a moment. After that, we're looking at pre-filling it with whatever we're pre-filling that field with. So in this case, we're going to pre-fill, in this example, the feature field, the feature ID field, and we're pre-filling it with best feature. But the next part is we're actually hiding it, and we're saying hide equals true, which is the part where we're going to actually hide that element yet still pre-fill it in the form URL. So let's take this one step at a time and build this in our example. So our form is here. We get the URL by going up to the share form, and we can copy this right to our clipboard. Let's head back to our contacts. The idea being that each time we send this form out, it's going to automatically be linked to the contact in question. So the first part we do is just drop in the form URL by itself. I strongly recommend doing this in a formula, and we're going to put that directly inside of either single or double quotes. I just paste in that URL. We go ahead and create this field, and of course we know this is going to be the exact same every time because there's no variable that we've added yet to the form URL. Now to take this a step further, we can shrink this back down. And what I'm going to do is now add the first element. And I'll call this first element. And the first element is going to be pre-filling that information. So let's see how we do this. Again, we'll use a formula here. And we're going to concatenate or string together multiple pieces of text. The first piece of text being that static form URL. So I'll call in the form URL field here. Now the next part I want to add is going to be the same every time. Question mark, prefill, underscore, and now we need to bring in whatever we are trying to prefill. What is the name of the field that we're pre-filling? Well, let's really quickly flip back to our form, but before we do that, let's save where we are in our formula. So I will put in some single quotes around this question mark prefill underscore element, and I'll go ahead and save that by creating this formula for now. I'm going to open up my form capture again, and now I'm going to open that form in another URL. Once that form opens up, we see that the element that we want to prefill is in fact the contacts link. So let's go ahead and copy the name of that field and head back to our formula in our contacts table. I'll open up that field again, and inside of those quotation marks, I'm going to just paste in the name of the field that we want to prefill, and I follow it up with an equal sign. Now, if you have any questions or get stuck here, I went into more detail on this very step in a previous video, like I already said, so do check that out. Now, for the part that I want to prefill, I want the record ID of this contact. So let's go ahead with a comma now, and I'll call upon the record ID in my formula, and that should do it for this step. So now, if I look at this particular output, we see that it's unique in every case because it is appending this URL with the record ID of the contact, which is unique every time. So if I were to open up this particular one and click on this link, it will open up a form that is already connected to the contact Gareth. Go back, let's do it again. We'll connect this time for Peter Pan, and there we go. We see the form is already pre-filled for Peter Pan. But the reason that we wouldn't want to send this particular form pre-filled just like this is, well, anybody can come in, X out the contact, and take a look at all of the other contacts in our database. So if you're doing anything that involves even the tiniest bit of sensitive data, you don't want to share it in this regard because now suddenly people can see everything else that lives in your database. So in this particular case, we would love to be able to not only prefill that particular field, but more importantly, then hide it. So let's go ahead and close out those open forms, and we're going to go back to our support document, and we're going to reference this last piece here. We say and hide underscore, and then again we have to bring in the name of the field equals true. So let's go ahead and add that to our first element formula here. I will create another formula here. We'll call this second element, just so that we can break this up into manageable bite-sized steps. I'm going to add this formula. And this time I want to concatenate, again, stringing together multiple strings of data. I want to start with my first element output. Call my first element here. And this is where we will say inside either single or double quotes, ampersand hide underscore contacts equals true in all lowercase. I'm going to go ahead and save this up. And what we see here is now a unique formula that has a unique record ID, but is telling us at the end that we want to hide the contacts field that is set to true. So let's go ahead and click on this and see what happens. We know that this particular link is filled out for Gareth, but we don't see that information anywhere. So we can send this link to Gareth, have him fill this out. He says, well, my favorite color is still blue. My favorite restaurant is still 801 Chop House. If you know, you know. Then I'm going to submit. And what do we expect to have happen on the back end? We can flip back into our form database table, and we see that a new submission was just received. If we look at this, we see it was just submitted via a form. And yes, it is in fact connected to the proper contact. If I go back to my contacts table and I click on this element for Peter Pan, it will open up a form presumably linked to Peter Pan, but we see that nowhere on the form. He says, well, my favorite color is still green. My favorite restaurant is still Mermaid's Lagoon Cafe. He submits that information. Again, we would expect this to be linked back in our form capture table, properly linked to Peter Pan, even though we didn't see that element actively appearing on the form. Now, what are the limitations of this? And should we be cautious about how we share this? Well, in case you're sharing this with anybody who knows what this is, you'll notice this note coming in here from Airtable where they say to use caution to not prefill values that may potentially violate privacy or compliance practices. So This feature is not a security measure. The prefilled value will be visible in the URL that is generated for the prefilled form. So what they're mentioning here is that that prefilled value is still showing up inside of that form URL. Now, in this case, I don't really care much if people know what the record ID is that's attached to their particular information in my Airtable database. But if there's some private information that you don't want to have visible to whoever you're sharing this form with, do know that it will be here in the form URL, so just keep that top of mind. Now, the other big thing that I wonder about is what happens if someone who's using this form decides to come in and change this particular piece to false. They could technically click whatever link you give them and change it to false. If they do that, I would expect, and sure enough, the element is showing up right there in the form. So I find it highly unlikely that anybody would ever do this, but you should be aware of the fact that it could happen because, yes, it does open you up to the same possibility that I talked about at the very beginning. And the reason that we don't share these forms is because, well, someone can come in, X out that contact, and again, see everyone that you're linked to. So of course, there are still workarounds for this. You might instead decide to enter that record ID rather than linking it right here in the form. You might instead capture it in a single line text field. That way, in case anyone did open up that element on the form and wanted to make it visible, I don't know why they would, but if they did, they wouldn't see a link to everything else. You would just capture that record ID, and then you could build an automation on the back end that properly took that record ID and automatically linked you to the corresponding record. An extra step to be sure, but if safety and privacy are of the utmost importance, which they should be, then it's probably a valid step to take just for that added security. But still, a really cool feature, the ability to hide this. Now you will notice one other thing, that back in my form setup, I did not actually hide this field in my form. The field remains present in the form itself. It was not moved and dragged to be a hidden field, but it is hidden in the prefill URL itself. So again, make sure to keep whatever elements that you want to hide in the actual form itself, and then append correctly those elements in your URL, and simply set the hide to be true. I hope you got a ton of value from this video and have started imagining dozens of ways that you can implement this new feature. Leave any questions or comments you have below, and if you want to stay on top of the latest news in no code, be sure to subscribe to this channel so you don't miss out on future videos. Thanks a lot, and I will see you in the next one.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program, and for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.